Sampanna Parijataya Totra Vetraika Panaye Gyana Mudraya Krishnaya Gita Amruta Duhe Namaha Om. Dear friends, we are now seeing the Bhagavad Gita chapter number 12, which is called the Bhakti Yoga. In that Bhakti Yoga, we are somewhere in the middle, and we were seeing that bhakti, or rather devotion, is a very important say means or strategy to attain say jnanam. So that is what we were seeing. That is, we have seen so many other means. For example, karma yoga, that was also a means. Yoga itself means an association with something, associating yourself with a strategy, and that is what is karma. In karma yoga, we are associating ourselves with what is called nishkama karma. In atmasayama yoga, we are associating with what is called atmasayama or self restraint, or restraining the sense organs and the mind. In samadhara yoga, dhyana yoga, we are associating ourselves with meditation and the techniques of meditation. So like that, we are seeing various types of association or various types of yogas we have been seeing. And in the last two episodes, we have seen what is called bhakti yoga. And I was saying what the commentators have written, that bhakti is in fact something to do with emotion. All other things, for example, karma yoga is something to do with action, atmasayama yoga also is something to do with some other type of activity, and dhyana yoga is another type of activity. So, but here bhakti yoga is something which is associated with an emotion, and that is the reason why we call it bhakti rasa. We never call it karma yoga rasa or atmasayama rasa, etcetera, etcetera. But then we call it bhakti rasam, because that is something which moves the mind. Whatever moves the mind is what is rasa. In fact, all these the people, literary critics, they talk about say rasa, navarasas, etc. in various kavyas. Kavya means the work of art. Any work of art is a kavya, and in any work of art there will be one sentiment, one predominant sentiment, and there are various other sentiments also. These sentiments are called rasas, and bhakti is something which is so important that it purifies. The point is, in karma yoga may get it is associated with a lot of strain, but here this bhakti, a simple surrender to the Lord, a simple surrender to say the divine, and not only the simple surrender but also associated with some type of understanding of the nature of divine, so that these are important here. So that is what purifies a person, and that is something like say exchanging, or rather discarding, our old samskaras, whatever are the bad samskaras which are there in us, and cultivating the new samskaras. So that is what we have seen in this bhakti yoga. And we have seen how this bhakta, a real bhakta, we are not talking about a business like bhakta, a person who goes say to the temple and he says, okay, if I get such a big contract, I am going to give you 1 crore rupees, I have to get say some 1,000 crores contract. So I will give you some 5 crores. So it is not, it is a business deal. We are not talking about a bhakta who is having a sort of business deal with the Lord. We are talking about a bhakta who may be an artha bhakta. Artha bhakta means somebody who is really in distress, and that person who becomes a devotee, and then gradually he becomes a real devotee. So we are talking about a jignyasu bhakta, we are talking about a jnani bhakta. Artho jignyasu arthaarthi, we have seen in 7th or 8th adhyaya. Artho jignyasu arthaarthi jnani cha bharatarshava. He was saying, Krishna was saying, that 4 types of people they come, they are 4 types of devotees, he says. One is an artha bhakta. Artha means somebody who is in distress. Jignyasu, somebody who wants to know what exactly is the truth. And then artharthi means a person who doesn't have any great say problems, but he wants something more. Then jnani is somebody who is a realized person, but at the same time he is also devoted. So we talked about all those 4 people. So here this bhakti is something which purifies the sentiments of a person. And in the last episode also we have been seeing santushtaha satatam yogi yatatma drudhanishchayah, etc., etc. we have seen. And then he continues like that, Krishna continues like that. And what we are seeing here is the qualities of a jnani, which were described earlier in the 2nd chapter. For example, Sankhya Yoga, where we saw the qualities of a sthita prajna. So the same thing we are going to see in the 13th chapter also, the qualities of a jnani. And the qualities of a bhakta also, they tally with that man. So that is, a person whose mind is purified, what will be his behavior? So that is what we have been seeing. A person who doesn't hate anybody. Say a person who is a santushta. Santushta means a person who is totally contented. So these are the qualities which we find both in a jnani and also in a bhakta. And then we are seeing this shloka. Yasman nodvijate lokaha, lokan nodvijate chayaha. This is the 15th shloka. Harshamarsha vayodyogaihi muktaha, yas sacha me priyaha. That is, yasmat na udvijate lokaha. That is, a person's conduct is so well purified that people do not get agitated by his behavior. That is, if I am functioning in a very crude, rough manner, people get agitated by my behavior. If I am offending somebody, the other man is offended. And I also take offense from my offense. For no reason, suppose I take offense. Even if you talk normally, and even suppose you have not smiled at me properly, then I take offense. So that means I am getting that udvega. So we are now talking about somebody, yasmat nodvijate lokaha. That is, people do not get agitated by his behavior. And he doesn't get agitated by the other people's behavior. So that means he has risen above these dualities. He has risen above this so-called mana apamana yoho. We have seen earlier also mana apamana yoho. He has risen above that. And then harsha amarsha bhayodvegaihi muktaha. Muktaha means he is totally devoid of. If somebody praises, he doesn't get elated. Harsha. Harsha means something which is happiness. You know the word harsha. And then when we are absolutely happy, we walk in a very proud manner, and in that proud manner, we are also likely to violate dharma. There is a saying in Sanskrit, that is, hrushto drupyati and druptaha dharma matikramati. That is, a person who is extremely happy, so that man, he is likely to be drupta. Drupta means he becomes proud, and a proud person, he is also likely to violate dharma. Real bhakta, he doesn't get elated, he is not afraid, bhaya, udvega again is something getting agitation, etc. So, he is devoid of all those things, he is free from all these emotions which are associated with the I and mine, which are basically associated with the ego. Then he also says anapekshah shuchir dakshah udasino gatavyathah sarvarambha parityagi yo madbhaktas same priyah. This is the 16th shloka. Some 4 more shlokas are there, like which are describing the qualities of a bhakta. That is anapekshah. Apeksha means you are expecting something from somebody. Apeksha is always expecting something. There is always an expectation. I expect that somebody has to respect me. I expect that somebody has to receive me like this, or I expect some other type of treatment. So when I don't get that, then I am unhappy. So a jnani is not having that apeksha. Similarly, a bhakta also is not having any sort of apeksha, anapeksha. That is, there is no question of expectation. There is no question of want in him. If only there is a want in me, then there is an expectation. Then shuchihi dakshaha. Shuchi means there are 2 levels of shuchi. Shuchi means cleanliness. What type of cleanliness? The external cleanliness of the body, my body, and also the internal cleanliness of the mind. That is bahya abhyantara shuchi, we call it. Bahya shuchi is external, and abhyantara shuchi is something to do with the mind and my thoughts, my emotions. So that is abhyantara shuchi. Shuchihi dakshaha. Daksha, then does it mean that a person who is a devotee or a person who is a jnani, is he totally withdrawing from samsara? Or rather, he is totally despising the world, is he totally scorning the world, is he totally disregarding all the people and then throwing them away? It is not like that. He loves people. It is not as though he is associated in an emotional manner, but at the same time, he doesn't show scorn, he doesn't scoff at them. And then he is also daksha. Daksha means, in English we can use the word dexterous. Dexterous is a word which is very close to this word daksha. It is, in fact, they are cognate words also. So, this daksha means somebody who is capable, somebody who is also doing something. In fact, we have seen in an earlier shloka, a very wonderful shloka, which says, a jnani is not a person who is sitting idle in some corner. A person who is, engaged in karma, he is doing his karma in a very, very active way. But then, does it mean that a jnani is somebody who is sitting in a corner, not trying to do anything? Not like that. He says, सक्ताः कर्मण्यविद्वांसः यथा कुर्वन्ति भारत कुर्याद् विद्वांस तथा असक्तः जस्ट एज एन इग्नोरेंट मैन इज एंगेज्ड इन एक्टिविटी इन अ वेरी वेरी एंथुजियास्टिक मैनर विद द सेम एंथुजियाज्म ए ज्ञानी आल्सो विल बी डूइंग सम वर्क बट विदाउट अटैचमेंट सो दैट इज व्हाट ही सेज तस्मा कुर्याद् विद्वांस तथा असक्तः फॉर व्हाट चिकीर्षुः लोकसंग्रहम इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द सोसाइटी इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ इन द से लोक संग्रह मीन्स से वेलफेयर ऑफ सोसाइटी वी कैन से लोकस्य उन्मार्ग प्रमा प्रवृत्ति निवारणम लोक संग्रह इट इज सेड दैट इज टू गाइड द पीपल इन अ प्रॉपर वे टू सी दैट पीपल आर नॉट मिसगाइडेड ए पर्सन परफॉर्म्स राइटियस एक्शन टू सी दैट पीपल आर नॉट मिसगाइडेड सो दैट इज व्हाट इज वी हैव सीन सो हियर दक्ष मीन्स द सेम then udasinah at the same time utasinah that means he is totally detached dispassionate we can say or rather disinterested there is another word called disinterested not uninterested uninterested means something I have absolutely no interest in anything that is uninterested disinterested means I am acting in a very maybe I am very seriously doing the job but I am disinterested in the sense I am above any type of selfish interest that is what is called disinterestedness udasinah gatavyathah He is not bothered, he is not worried about it, he is not emotionally attached to that. Then sarva arambha parityagi yomad bhakta same priya. Arambha means always trying to do something. What next, a question will be there. Suppose I do some, I finish one job, then there will be some question, what next. So this jnani, he is not like that. Whatever comes to him, he does it in a very, very easy manner. That is his nature. Then yo na hrushyati na dveshti na shochati na kankshati. So then again he slightly in a different way he is saying that is a person who is above this harsha harsha means happiness and dvesha enmity he is above these two sentiments called happiness and also dvesha enmity or hatred he is neither he doesn't rejoice in anything nor does he hate anything and then he doesn't grieve and then he doesn't desire also na shochati na kankshati he doesn't desire also And then Shubha Ashubha Parityagi, then he is somebody who is not interested in the devotee, a real devotee, he is somebody who is not interested in doing various punya karya. Devotee does not mean somebody who is always performing some yajnas for the sake of punya, etc. He is a karmi. Karmi we have to slightly distinguish from a devotee. A person who is always trying to do something and then trying to acquire some punya, etc., he is a karmi. But then a devotee is somebody who loves God. Who loves God and then he is and we have seen in this bhakti there is no big paraphernalia patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhaktya prayachati you can just be there you can just carry a flower you can just carry a fruit you can just carry some little small gift so that itself is enough it doesn't require much paraphernalia a lot of money and then lot of pompous exhibition it is not needed there so that is what it is Shubha Ashubha Parityagi, that means he is above this Punya and Papa level. Bhaktiman Yasame Priyaha, this is what Krishna is saying, such a devotee I like him. Then he says, Samashyatraucha Mitrecha, Tatha Manapamana Yoho, Sitoshna Sukha Dukheshu Samas Sangha Vivarjitaha. Then again we are talking about a jnani almost. In fact, we are not making a distinction between a jnani and a jnani bhakta. Because a person who is devoted to God in a very, very, disinterested manner, let us say, totally without any ego, his emotions get purified. And then that is what happens to him. Samaha Shatrauja Mitrecha. He doesn't see any enemy. And then he is equal to the friend and also the enemy. Then Tatha Mana Apamana Yoho. Mana means honor. Apamana is dishonor. In fact, in Sanskrit, there is a saying, if somebody insults you, it is good for your tapas it increases the tapas shakti it says avamana tapo labha sammanatu tapakshaya that is if somebody is finding fault with you for something then it is tapo labha in the sense that you start thinking about it okay this man has said like this what is wrong with me is there anything wrong with me is there any correction which is needed within me so that is what we see Sammanattu tapashchaya. If somebody honors you, oh, he is such a great man, he is such a medhavi, etc., etc., then you think, oh, yes, I have nothing more. So that is a tapashchaya. In fact, incidentally, I was just reading Ramayana the other day when we are seeing this episode of Vishwamitra. In Ramayana Balakanda, there is an episode in that there is a fight between, a fight in the sense, a spiritual fight, let us say. Not even a spiritual fight, a sort of metaphorical fight between Vishwamitra and Vasishtha. The fight is not between Vishwamitra and Vasishtha, Vishwamitra is a king and Vasishtha is a Brahmin, it is not that. The fight is between Sattvaguna and Rajoguna. And then prior to that, Vishwamitra is somebody who, prior to that, say Rama, I mean Valmiki, there is an episode which shows that say Rajo, I mean Tamoguna, we know that there are three gunas, Tamoguna, Sattvaguna, Rajoguna and Sattvaguna. This Tamoguna has to be eradicated. How is Tamoguna eradicated? Tamoguna has to be eradicated by Rajoguna. And then Rajas has to be, overcome by Sattvaguna. So earlier there is an episode which shows that Tamoguna is eradicated or overcome by Rajoguna. And when we come to Vishwamitra and Vasishtha, then Vishwamitra picks up a fight with Vasishtha, because we all, in fact most of us, we have even seen this movie relating to Vishwamitra. Vishwamitra is engaged in a great tapas, and then Indra sends, causes all types of disturbances, including sending a damsel called Menaka, and then he falls in love with her, and then after some time he realizes that he has wasted his tapas. That is, it is actually a test. There in Vedanta, whenever the word Deva is used, Deva does not mean a god who is sitting above. Deva actually means our own sense organs are devas. Devas means Indriyani. Deva in wherever, in most occasions, let us say, in very many occasions in Vedanta, Deva actually means Indriya. So there, the lesson is that Vishwamitra has not attained the Indriya Jaya. And then the whole episode of Vishwamitra and Vasishtha is actually a sort of spiritual growth of Vishwamitra, and then how he overcomes Kama, how he overcomes Krodha, and then this Kama and Krodha are two important factors in this Rajoguna. And then how after overcoming these two emotions, then only he becomes equal to Vasishtha, who is a person who is settled in Sattvaguna. So that is what is the say message there. There, when coming to this mana apamana yoho, I was trying to explain this word mana apamana. Vishwamitra, when he was performing a yajna, there he dispatches his disciples to summon various type of all rishis to perform a particular yajna. That particular yajna was designed to send Trishanku with his physical body to heaven. So when he was performing that type of yajna, he wanted lot many rutviks. So he said, okay, bring so many people, and also tell me what each man talks about it. I am performing this yajna. You report to me as to how various people they react. And then the shishyas, they come and say, okay, everybody was silent only, but only the sons of Vasishtha, they found fault with your yajna. How can this gentleman do yajna? How can he send a person physically to heaven? So that is what they said. Then he becomes very furious, he becomes angry, and then curses the sons of Vasishtha to turn into ashes, etc. So there we see that anger. And then mana apamana yoho, we are seeing that he is so much interested in what other people think about him. Other people, are they making a good comment about him? Other people, are they criticizing him? So a jnani is a person who is not bothered about this. A jnani simply does his job. He is not bothered about what other people think of him. So that is what we see. There the shishyas, they come and say, and then he immediately curses. So there again he loses some tapas. So every time he becomes furious, he loses some tapas. Every time he betrays his weakness for kama, let us say, there again he loses his tapas. So that is the point here. Then similarly, sitoshna sukha dukheshu, that is the physical dvandvas, physical dualities. In fact, I strongly recommend that you please read that whole episode of relating to Vishwamitra and Vasishtha, about 10 sargas in Ramayana, 10 to 15 sargas. This entire spiritual journey of Vishwamitra, from an ordinary egotistic king, he becomes a rajarshi, and then he is called a rishi, and later he is called a Maharshi, and he is not satisfied with that, and ultimately when he overcomes the entire Rajoguna, totally eliminates the Rajoguna from his mind, then he is called a Brahmarshi. So that entire spiritual journey is so beautifully described by Valmiki. So Shitoshna Sukadukeshu, this particular angle also is described there, where he sits in the midst of what is called Pancha, Agni, Pancha Agnihi, Pancha Agnayaha. So in between the five Agnis means on all four sides he has fire, and in the burning, in the hot sun, he is standing in the hot sun with all four, with fire on four sides. So that type of tapas. So Shita Ushna Sukadukeshu Samaha Sangha Vivarjitaha. Then he is just not concerned, he is not attached to anything. Then Tulya Nindas Sutirmauni, then again another way of saying Mana Apamana Yoho, that is Tulya Nindas Sutihi. He is just not bothered when there is a Ninda or whether there is a Stuti. Then Mauni, Mauni is another important thing. Mauni is Mananat Munihi, we say. Mananam is something meditation. Meditation on what? Meditation on the nature of reality. So that is what is mananam. Meditation on the nature of reality is what is mananam. Mananat Mauni. Then Santushtaha Yena Kena Chit. He is satisfied with anything. Then Aniketaha. This is another important word. Aniketaha means Niketanam means what? Niketanam means a particular place of residence. Niketana is something somewhat like address. I am at this particular place. Aniketa means addressless. So it means two things. That is, a person who is not fixed to a place, that is one ordinary meaning. Aniketa, at a slightly higher level, it means he has gone beyond this identification with the body-mind complex. His idea of self, it has undergone a change. Aniketa, that is, he is not somebody who is identifying himself with the body-mind complex. That is what is Aniketa. Then Sthiramatihi, Bhaktiman, Sachame Priyonaraha. Then the last shloka he says, Yetu Dharmyamrutamidam Yathoktam Paryupasate Shraddhadhana Matparama Bhaktaste Tivame Priyaha. Then he says, so this particular strategy which is called Bhakti, it is called Dharmyamrutam. Dharmyamrutam is something which is nectar-like. Dharmyamrutam, nectar-like thing which is in accordance with Dharma. It is not as though it doesn't mean simply because you are a bhakta, you are not doing karma yoga, you are not doing atma sanyama yoga. There is no disqualification like that. This bhakti is something which is above all, and then it purifies. Straight away it takes you to a slightly higher level. So that is what we see here, and that is how we come to the end of this 12th chapter. And in the next episode, we will take up what is called Kshetra Kshetrajna Vibhaga Yoga, that is the 13th chapter, a slightly difficult chapter, we will take up in the next episode. Harihi Om Tat Sat.